2 minutes to go. LSU on a 6-0 run. Mississippi State has not scored since the 6:46 mark here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you have the threat of Poe and Rogers along with Jessica Carter inside. Oh, quick hands by Flajay Johnson.
No, that's Anissa Morrow.
Oh, Anissa Morrow it is.
Jump ball, possession arrow, Mississippi State as Pola ties it up.
It was a quick pick like Flajay Johnson.
Yeah.
But it was Morrow.
Give credit.
You got you. I got you. Morrow has just had a hard time finishing her layups tonight.
She's 6-for-18 from the field.
You don't want to be in that corner. That's a good job. Get out of there quick. And Sam Purcell's even coaching the crowd, telling them to settle down.
5.5 minute scoring drought for Mississippi State. Rogers goes swish. And Michaela Williams airball.
Darren Rogers. Her mom and daddy are in town. Showing up for the folks, her people, and Sam Purcell struck a pose. He's loving it.
Darian Rogers is at 4 threes. There's going to be a foul before that shot.
I think Darian Rogers had a little extra motivation playing against a former teammate of hers from DePaul. She has been locked and loaded. 6 of 9 from the floor, 4 of 7 from the three-point line.
Last four games coming in, Rogers was 0-for-8.
But it's still a two-possession game. LSU chose the foul. They still have another one to give.
LSU 3 timeouts, Mississippi State with 1. Angel Reese almost took that away. And there's the last one for LSU to give. So next foul will put Mississippi State at the free throw line.
Now, Mississippi State is a pretty good free throw shooting team. As a team, they shoot about 72%.
That's the fourth on Flajay Johnson. And that should put Mississippi State at the free throw line.
See now, for LSU, do they really want to foul Jessica Carter, who shoots 62%? Miracle Shepherd, and she's a 60% shooter from the free throw line.
This is the first. LSU can call timeout here and advance the ball. Kim Mulkey will do that. 46.4 showing on the clock.
Now, one of her best three-point shooters, Michaela Williams, is not in the game, the freshman. I don't think Kim Mulkey was happy with that last three-point shot that she took.
She's 0-for-2 tonight from deep.
Now, LSU can go for a quick two, and I go to Angel Reese inside, because more times than not, Angel Reese is going to get the bucket and probably get her a trip to the free throw line. If that shot's not there, then you have that three-point option. Flajay Johnson or Haley Van Lith.
But how quickly do they have to do that?
They've got to go quick. They've got to go the first available shot that's there. They cannot use a lot of the shot clock in this situation right now. Now, on the other side, Mississippi State still has three fouls to give. So they could foul LSU. They just want to make sure that they are not fouling when LSU is in the act of shooting.
Possession arrow is pointing LSU's way. Again, they took that timeout to advance the basketball to be right next to LSU's bench.
You got to compliment how prepared Sam Purcell has had his team for today. Even runs that LSU made, they didn't get rattled. They still maintain their composure. And he told us this morning he just wanted his team to embrace the moment and enjoy it, have fun. And they looked to have done that.
So last tier Polo will inbound. They go straight to Angel Reese, back over to Haley Van Lith, who puts up a quick three and misses, but Angel Reese is there, gets fouled, and she will have free throws coming. That foul on Darion Rogers. Her second.
I like the play of going inside to Angel Reese, because she knew the defense was going to attract to her, and then the kick out to Haley Van Lith.
Angel Reese is a 74% free throw shooter. She makes more free throws per game than anyone in the nation. 5 of 6 tonight. This is the first.
It's still a two-possession game.
And now Sam Purcell will call timeout. He can advance the ball. This is Mississippi State's final timeout. How quickly does LSU have to foul?
They've got to foul right away. I think they've got to foul, especially when you have Miracle Shepherd miss one of her free throws. Jessica Carter, not a strong free throw shooter. And you try to lengthen this game as much as possible.
Kayla Jordan with 23 points, 3 for 3 from 3 tonight.
You also have DeBrisha Poe. That's also a good option.
So Rogers will be inbound.
Now Rogers inbound in the basketball. They had a long conversation of whether or not she can make certain passes. She was real honest with her coach. You got to have that kind of communication.
Again, Mississippi State does not have a timeout. They have to get this ball in. And LSU has brought the pressure. They do. They get it to Dracayla Jordan.
That's who you want to have the ball.
And LSU's got a foul, and Issa Morrow does.
Yeah, Jordan, an 80% free throw shooter.
2 for 2 tonight for Dracayla Jordan. Ninth time this season she's had 20 or more points in a game.
Going to make LSU wants a timeout.
So Kim Mulkey uses her second to last timeout. She can advance the ball once again. 37.3 seconds left. Want to remind you, Texas Baylor coming up on Thursday. You can see that game on ESPN.
The ball to go to inside and then to Haley Van Lith. She put Flajay Johnson back in the game as well. She's hit a three tonight, so she could be an option from the three-point line also.
and lives for three.
Big rebound by Williams.
Up and in. And LSU calls its final timeout. Well, for Mississippi State, Jerkayla Jordan has been the do-it-all player today. 24 points, her ninth time with 20 or more points in a game.
She's perfect from the three-point line, but she's done a little bit of everything for Mississippi State. She said she was focused. She said she had taken notes on her scouting report, and she talked about that LSU had to worry about them, and she has demonstrated just why tonight.
So Michaela Williams quickly fouls Darian Rogers. She's an 86% free throw shooter. 24.3 on the clock.
And Rogers has had herself a night tonight. 4 of 8 from three.
First trip to the free throw line for Rogers this evening. Again, LSU does not have a timeout, so they will have to go the length of the floor.
Now LSU did a nice job into the first, into the second quarter in their executions. So now what do they have in their bag to come quick? The final 24 seconds.
Rogers gets them both. Back to a 6-point lead. And Miracle Shepherd fouls Haley Van Lith.
Well, because Mississippi State's got fouls to give. Now, I think that Miracle Shepherd probably fouled a little bit too early in the clock. Mississippi State still has another foul to give.
Sam Purcell looking for his first top 25 win at Mississippi State, and as a head coach, they have not beaten a top 10 team since 2018. Michaela Williams, they needed it desperately, her first three tonight, and LSU's got a foul right now. 15 seconds on the clock.
Don't go anywhere yet.
Monster bucket.
Michaela Williams just ice cold off the ball screen. Pure from the top of the key.
Darian Rogers back to the free throw line. This is the first.
So now LSU make or miss, get it on the push. Right, now I'd say drive it hard, then looking for a shooter.
4-point game. Michaela Williams short on the three. And Mississippi State, yabba dabba doo, right to a top 25 win.
Yabba dabba doo moments